Hi guys. Well, I got a bit bored last night, so I took this old Sky Plus HD box apart. Well, I say old, it's not actually old. Because they have these inside. That is a Seagate hard drive 500 GB. I have found that the size will vary depending on the age of the box. I may even put this back together and use it minus the hard drive, because I'd never use the record feature on one of these. Anyway, let's get this cables out of the way. There's the Molex power connector for the power cable, in case people don't believe me that you get hard drives in here, because no doubt there'll be someone that goes, you don't get hard drives in them. Yes, you do. There's the power cable, and on top of this one, there's the SATA connector. I'm going to keep these cables, so I'll be handy. Yeah, I could easily put this all back together if I wanted to. Some kids going past. I don't know. I could just leave it as it is. We'll see. The power board is actually incorporated with all this gear. With all the, there's RF aerial in, RF out. Oh no, that's RF out. Oh, that's aerial in. Duh. That's RF out. That's RF out too. Oh, there's two RF outputs on these. Dish inputs. One and two. AV output. Coaxial. Optical. Power in. SCART and all the rest is on the other board. We've got the other board. There's the Sky Dish in and out. HDMI. Ethernet. USB. External SATA. Phone. And whatever that is. Serial port for something, I'm guessing. And that would just slot back in there like that. Make sure we get those header cables all lined up and plugged in. There we go. Now, if I just put the necessary nuts and washers and things back on that, I could put all the covers back together, put all the front panel back on, put all the covers back on, and it would still be usable. That'll still function minus the hard drive, in the sense that you'd still be able to watch TV with them, but you just wouldn't be able to use the record features on them as these Sky HD boxes have, hence the hard drive. We've got cable here. Where the hell does that go? There's got to be a header for it somewhere. There's the fan. I suppose the fan is just on there to keep the hard drive cool. I can't imagine or see any other reason, because that's where the hard drive goes, right in this area here. So you actually had to dismantle the whole machine just to get the hard drive out. Ah, there's the header for this. I knew there was one somewhere. Oh yeah, that's right, because that was zip-tied to the SATA cable. Okay. So, I hope you know I'm doing all this one-handed. What's this? Ah! So these little washers go on first. I've got little tabs which line up with some holes on the actual back of the box. Like so. And then I've got two normal washers to sit on top, and then two nuts. set the washers on. Screw the nuts on. I'll put them on loosely just for the time being. Be interesting to know if I can get the front panel air back on, because it's not screwed on, it's only on with some like metal twist tabs. There's one right there for the lid, and the problem is with them, you can only twist them so many times before they'll snap. Oh well, gone all the way down with that one, I might as well do the other one there. Might as well do them both while I'm at it. I'll tighten them up with a pair of pliers later. And then we've got the serial port standoffs here, not the standoffs, the securing posts for whatever you plug into it. Like so. Here's the other one. There's the other one. Oddly, there's not that many screws in this, to be honest. I'll do those up with the pliers later. Where's that sit now? No idea. Right. We're getting there. I can't sit down because he's asleep on the chair. Put my hard drive over there. Ah. Can't remember where that came from. Oh well. We chuck it over there. It's obviously not that important. And that one's the power for the front. Yeah.
Oh.
Looks like we've got another cable missing. We've got two cables missing. Hang on. I'll just sit you somewhere there. You should be in shot because I've got to kneel down on the floor. Say my prayers while I'm down here. Right. This is going to be a bit fiddly because I've got this button board here with a little bit of ribbon flex soldered between them. That's got to clip onto this plastic bit here, like so. Then I've got to get this one all lined up with all the lock and tabs, hopefully. Oh, I was going to say, bloody come off there. There we go. Then I could do this like a needle nose, a pair of pliers. Hang on, I'll just get one out of my box. I've got something here, that means we should have. Okay, no, I haven't. Right. So it's the big chunky pair of pliers there. All you do with these metal tabs is just give them a twist, that lock it in place. I don't suppose it matters what way you twist them. There we go. Right. This big cable here then goes in here. Like so. And I think that's actually it for that. Yep, we stick the metal cover back on the top, and I've got one more cable to plug into the front panel. Now, that's got to hook under that back bit there. I'll just pull it out again so you can see. And this goes. I can get it to go into place. Can be a bit fiddly because you've got to get it on that back properly. Now, just like the front, that's easy, just reverse to take it off and just twist the tabs and make sure these little metal tabs are in line with the slots in the circuit board, then that'll just pull straight off. But it's a lot easier if you can find a small pair of pliers or needle nose pliers. Then you do the same with this top and just twist the tabs back over to lock it in that place. And then of course you've got to connect the top buttons to the front panel, which simply plug into there like that. And like I said, of course, dismantling, you just do the complete reverse. There is a screw to go in there and in there, and I'll find those later. And apart from the hard drive screws, there is only two screws in the back here that help hold the circuit board in place, and two screws that hold this lot together. And that's the next bit to put on, which is going to be a little bit fiddly. I will need void. Well, it is now, but wasn't it? Certainly is now. Right. Put the fan plug back in, didn't I? And I actually found this pretty awkward to get out, so I'm going to assume it's going to be pretty awkward to get it back in. Oh, no, it slid straight back in. That just clips together like that. And then you've got just these two side panel pieces. Should clip on like that and then slide forwards like so. And I forgot, there's also a screw to hold these. There's a screw there, so you've got to take out that screw. Then you've got to lift this tab up, and then this whole silver panel will slide that way. That will actually let you get access to the clips holding this together to pull out the metal box. So we'll just do the same on the other side. These silver covers will only go on one way, so they just lock in like that. So apart from just tightening a few things up with the pliers and a couple of screws, we are back together. Look, you could do that to your parents' skybox and I'll never know you've been in there. Until I go to record a program and it's like, it don't work now. Stupid skybox. I've just got to remember what screw is what. I think these two longer ones, they go in here, down into these two holes, like so. I'll have to put those in. Another long one there, and I can't remember what the long one go to. A lot of those short, stubby ones are for the hard drive. Okay. Stick it up on end. I've got a feeling it's these two little ones for this. Which most of them look like they're the same size anyway, so I don't suppose that would matter. As long as the screw goes in the screw hole, it don't matter, does it? One more. No, apart from apart from the void sticker being removed, you'd never know anyone's been in here. I'm gonna stick one in there. The HDMI socket. So, one more to go between the dish inputs. And I've just got a ton of screws spare down there that I don't really need. Oh, I have just remembered, there is one, I'll just open up the cover to show you, where your Sky viewing card goes, there is one that goes in there. That's just a dinky little one. No, I don't think I'd put the right one in there. Don't think, hang on. Nope. Need a longer one. That's a hard drive screw. That ain't gonna be the right one, is it? There we go. I think that's the one. Or is it? Oh well, there's a screw in it now. Okay, done. All back together. Oops, nearly fell over. Right, as I didn't know how to take one of those apart, I didn't film it, because that would have been too... Well, it was awkward enough as it was. A couple of screws on the floor I need to pick up. So, yeah. Taking that part will just be the reverse. I'll just do a quick recap. You've got to take that screw out. Well, no. Start again. You've got to take that screw off. And that screw off. Then you've got to pick up this tab on both sides. You just lift that up and then push the plastic silver covers back. You got a screw there to take out, a screw there to take out, and that'll allow you to separate this bit of plastic from the top, which will allow you to pop metal box out. It also locks in with a tab there. Then you've got the metal cover, which you just twist four metal twist locks on them to get the cover off. It's as simple as that. And you're in like Flynn, as Dave on the EEV blog would say. Easy peasy when you know how. And now I know how to do them, I can get some more. These don't actually cost a lot to buy second hand. So if you're looking for a cheap SATA drive, keep in mind the size will vary depending on age and model of the Skybox, but I think the smallest I've ever had out of one is a 350 gig. The older ones, really older ones, in the all white box, they actually have IDE drives in, and I do have one I can show you. Got one, I think it's down here. Yep. This one came out of a very old, sort of one of the first gen Skyboxes where you could record your TV programs. That's an IDE. I'm not sure of the size. Does it say anywhere on here? It's another Seagate, so they must have a contract with Seagate. No, it doesn't actually say. It's got the jump settings on there and voltage ratings. Number of heads and cylinders, etc. And that's it. And the model number. I suppose I could Google the model number. Yeah. So if you can actually find any of the first sort of generation Sky Plus boxes, this is Sky Plus HD, these ones. So you'd want the old Sky Plus boxes, which are completely white. If you want an old IDE drive, I'm sure you could probably pick them up cheap at car boot sales and whatnot nowadays. I think the most I've ever seen a Sky Plus HD box go for second hand is £10. So for £10 you could have up to a 500GB SATA hard drive. I think it's worth it just for that, personally. have a quick look on eBay. I think I'll go for a bit more on eBay. Seeing as people tend to bid crazily on eBay sometimes. So, let's have a look. See if I can find some. Let's put Sky Box. I wonder if we can get any of the old analog stuff. That's all buy it now, so it's likely to be new. Oh, there's one. See? One bid, £10. For exactly what I've got. That's got 3D as well. Let's do auction only, not the Bartnows. Let's have a quick flick. There's another one there, £21. Ooh, that one's going for £62, but if that's right, that's got a 2TB drive in it. If that's what the 2TB means. Someone asking 20. This is the one. These white ones. They're the ones that have the old IDE drive in. There you go, 99p. That cost you a bit in postage, though. There's another one for £10. See, you can get them pretty cheap if you just look hard enough. Probably a lot cheaper than what it would cost you to actually go and buy the hard drive itself alone. So, if you're short or tight on a budget like I am, and can't really afford like a brand new bloody hard drive, then go get one of these. They're cheaper. Get yourself a Sky Digital. Got my teeth in a twist. My tongue in a twist, I should say. Yeah, I can't even get that sound right, can I? Go and get yourself a Sky Digital box. It's got to be an HD box, though. Either a Sky Plus, or a Sky Plus if you want an IDE drive, or a Sky HD if you want a Hoojima Flippy drive. SATA hard drive. You know, you could get one there for a penny and have a hard drive for a penny. Postage is quite high on these. There is a fair bit of weight to these boxes. So I suppose if they're using Royal Mail, that postage would be about right. Can't believe how cheap some of them are. Oh, and I'm actually gonna, while we're on the subject of electrical and whatnot, before I shut the camera down. No, actually, second thoughts, I'll talk about that in another video. So, yeah, that's the video on how to get you to, well, I didn't show how to take it apart, but I have explained it, I hope, and shown you how to reassemble one, which is basically just the reverse of how you take it apart. But in this case, you just reverse what I did to take it apart. And you get yourself a hard drive. This Skybox was actually given to me, so that was technically a free hard drive, so I'm not really fussed if that works now or doesn't, but I've taken them out of these boxes before on older models. And they have worked perfectly fine without the hard drive in, so you should be fine if you still wanted to use. If, like me, you don't really watch TV on the rare occasion, or whatever, then you probably wouldn't use the record feature anyway. But so, you just take out your hard drive, and if that 500 gig one works, because it was making some weird noises when it was in this. But as far as I know, it still functioned. As long as it does work, I'm going to put it in the main PC to give me a terabyte's worth of storage. Not that I really need a terabyte, but it's either that, or I could build a secondary PC. That I could upgrade. Because, I do have another Windows 7 PC through there. I could just build up for a spare PC in case that one decides to shit the bed for whatever reason. You never know. With computers, they can just... One day they'll be working like this, and then I could go to it tomorrow. After shutting it down tonight, the thing won't work. Who knows? I've had computers do that. And it just makes you think, well, the bloody thing was working last night when I went to bed. Anyway, that's it for this video, so thanks for watching, and I'll talk to you again in the next video. Bye!